Yeah, I think we're gonna do it. You know, I'm feeling kind of confident. Will those be my last words before disaster? Well, I guess we'll find out together. But with my limited knowledge today, we are going to try to dye my hair. I Googled things. I watched YouTube videos. I found a really good video where a hairdresser had a client that had similar hair to me, the dark roots and the light ends, and they were taking them from that color to a cool ash brown. And they showed the exact formula in the video. I'll put it in the description. But basically, I just got what they used. Disclaimer, I'm not a professional. This might go well and this might go very poorly. We're gonna find out. I paint as a hobby, and one of my favorite things about painting is that if you make a mistake, you simply just cover it up with more paint. And so I'm trying to take that approach into this. If I mess it up, we'll just go, we'll get it done. It's gonna be okay. But I wanna try my hand because about 3.5 months ago, I did go to the salon and I did get my copper and red hair covered up with a cool tone brown. And I let the stylist know that I wanted to go 6 months in between visits and wanted it to match my roots. And she gave me something that looked really good when I walked out of the salon, but unfortunately it faded in like 3 weeks. I went to an art festival like a week ago and my boyfriend was recording, and then the camera got my hair and it looked so red and it looked so bad with those dark roots, and from that moment I was like, I gotta figure something out. But see, when I went to the salon 3.5 months ago, it costed $300 to get my hair done. For it to fade that quickly. So we're gonna try this out, and if we can do this, that's gonna be great, because all of the supplies that I got were about $60, so not too shabby compared to $300. If I mess this up and then I have to spend $360 in total, then well, I guess I'll just take the L and my budget will hate me. We've got the color, and then we've got the fill color. My limited understanding is that because I have light hair and I want to take it to brown, which is much darker, I need to fill it to go from this light level over to the darker level. These are my two colors for filling the hair. I also have 10 volume developer over here, which apparently is good because I don't need to lift my hair. I just need to deposit the color. So these two, we've got 6G and 6RB, so light golden brown and light raspberry brown. I didn't want to have too much red and orange because, I mean, I've already got quite a bit, so I'm thinking gold will be nice. Well, then this one is 6RB and it's got some brown in there, so hopefully this will deepen the color for the fill and make it easier to get my gold color after I put these on. So we've got 5N and 6A right here. 6A is a dark ash blonde, and then 5N is a light brown. We've got two pairs of gloves. We've got two bowls, which is pretty cool. Wait, oh, they accidentally gave me three. This was a pickup order. They accidentally gave me three. Wait, that's pretty good. Shoot, I'm not mad at that. Sally's, you didn't see that. And then two brushes. Again, this was a pickup order, so I like that they gave me a pink one. Before I start, I'll give you a little 360 of the hair. So this is it. Show you the top. The lighting in here is pretty cool, so just for reference of what you're looking at it in. And yeah, that's it. Oh, I'm glad I did this now. Can you imagine me trying to do this when there's product in my hair? Ain't no way, bro. Oh, this is gonna be real cute for the internet. What did she do for the back? Wait. What if we just do this? That seems fine. That seems fine. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. Okay, let me see what this is looking like. I mean, that's pretty all right to me. Hoo-wee. Okay, sure. Sure.
Okay, that feels more manageable. Now the two, like, those two sections, it feels a lot better than just the one section that I had before. Okay, so now I can let these out. I guess we'll start mixing things up. Okay, so I just did some math literally on the box. Can you tell I overthink everything? Anywho, so we're gonna do 2 ounces of 6G, 0.30 ounces of 6RB. It's a 1-to-1 ratio with the developer and the dye. So I just did some math so that I know as I'm putting it on the scale what the total means. So we did some math because we really don't want to mess this up. I only put the color on the blonde parts of my hair. I didn't really worry about my roots considering that this color is just meant to cover up that blonde. So didn't have to be super, super precise when it came to my roots, but I did make sure that all of the blonde was covered and that I didn't miss any spots. I also tried my best to saturate the hair completely because I have watched way too many Brad Mondo videos to make that mistake. Thank you, Brad Mondo. I'm using my hands because I attempted to use the brush on like the first section and it kind of just made it harder for me, to be honest. Okay, so I have finished the filler color. It's looking a bit dark, so we'll see what happens. I forgot to put Vaseline around my hairline, so this will probably stain, but it shouldn't be too bad. It's been 32 minutes in total since I started. I started a stopwatch when I began the process, and then it's been 5.5 minutes since I stopped putting more color on. And also, this mirror was a pretty good idea, because I could see pretty much what was happening in the back of my head, so that was pretty cool. That was pretty cool. And then this is what we're looking like back there. The shirt is not white any longer, but oh well, oh well. Okay, so I checked and it should process for about 20 minutes. So I've got 8 minutes left. So we're gonna say hi to Mango. We're gonna say hi to Mango. Oh, he's the baby. Oh, there she is. Oh, you were napping, huh? I'm sure you were napping. Hi! Oh, what a good sit that was. I know I smell weird, don't I? Hi, Mango! Oh, what a sweet girl. Hello. Say hi to YouTube. Say, we have a vlog of getting me, but we haven't edited it yet. So maybe it'll be on YouTube. Maybe it won't be. Hopefully one day it will. But I'm a sweet, precious little girl. Mango. Mango with the mug. Mango likes her mug. She eats the mug. And she eats the handle. Mango. Okay, so we've washed it out, and it's time for the reveal. I mean, but it's wet, so. It's dark. It's dark, y'all. You can definitely see the red. So, yeah, I'm excited to see this dry. Let's do it. Okay, so this is what we're working with. You can definitely see that rim. I'm really not mad at it. I could leave it like this, but I know it'll fade. So I don't wanna leave it like this. Let me bring you up to the light. Yeah, now you can really see it. See all that red? That's what we are going to cancel out. Okay, so we're just gonna keep on pushing. You've already seen me section it and everything, so I'll just give you a couple updates as I keep going, and I guess we'll just finish it out. All right, so we have sectioned the hair. I was definitely much faster at it this time than last time.
Okay, once again, I did my math on my box. Last time, I barely had enough hair dye to like completely cover everything, so I'm doing a little bit more than what the hairdresser did in the video. I'm doing 1.5 ounces, 1.5 ounces, and then 3 ounces of the developer. Mission accomplished. We've done it. Yippee! I'm enjoying the box math. I thought it was extra at first, but I think I might have made a mistake if I didn't do the box math, so. All right, so I didn't forget Vaseline for this last round. So I put it on there and I opened the door to the bathroom so that I could get some more ventilation. My baby hair had dye that was on it and then it proceeded to get caught in my eye, which was not the most fun. So you see me there getting eye wash. Then it was all good, so we kept going along, saturating our hair, making sure we got everything. I did use that extra color that I mixed, so I'm really glad that I, you know, put that extra in there. So yeah, just making sure that everything is good. I just finished putting all of the color on, and I honestly felt more comfortable with it that time. I'm just gonna chill, let it process, and yeah, then I'll, I guess I'll see you then. Hey, so we're done. It's rinsed out. It's underneath this towel. It's gonna look brown. Surprise, it's brown. I'm gonna dry it. Let's dry it. It rhymes with can too. I've lost my marbles. It's 2:56 in the morning. But I'm committed. I'm committed. So we're gonna finish this. All right. So this is it. I like it. This is the 360. I mean, for the first time I've ever dyed my hair on my own, I kind of surprised myself. I'm really not mad at it. Let me show you up at the light. So, let's see, before I wanna say that the red was a lot more noticeable, I think that, you know, there's gotta be red in brown, so it's bound to have some in there, and I don't want like a flat brown. That's the whole reason why I filled it with the red. So, yeah, I mean, I am excited to see what it looks like tomorrow after I sleep with my heatless curler in and add some texture to it, put on some makeup, and do the whole shebang. But I mean, it is very late. It's 3 in the morning, so I am ready to call it a night and say that I think that was a success. All right, so this is what it's looking like with the whole shebang. I did my makeup. We've got curls in the hair. This is what it looks like from the back. Yeah, I think I like it. I think that the thing that's throwing me off a little bit is that it's just so dark from what I'm used to, because I've had blonde in my hair for so long now. But I mean, my roots match, my eyebrows match, because this is my natural color. And yeah, I mean, with my bangs like this, it frames my face well. So, I mean, no complaints, especially for it being my first time dyeing my hair. And this is what it's looking like in the light. I'll also show you this side. So yeah, I mean, maybe when I look at it in the sun, I'll see some more dimension, and as it fades, maybe the blonde that I had underneath it will show, but I guess we'll see. Let's ask Mango what she thinks of it. Mango, what do you think of my hair? Do you like it? Do you like my hair? Or are you just weepy? Are you sweepy? We went and played fetch, didn't we? Yeah, we did. So here we are underneath the sunlight. I feel like you can definitely see that red. It's funny because it kind of like matches that tree right behind me. But yeah, I mean, I like it. But yeah, thank you for watching. Bye.